Hi, in this video lecture, now we will study about those reactions in detail which results into electric current, that is those chemical reactions that can produce electric current, or we say where chemical energy is converted into electrical energy, right? And in the previous video lecture, we are already introduced to electrochemistry, right? And the two types of reactions, electrolysis and electromotive chemistry, where one type of reaction where chemical energy is converted into electrical energy, and one type of reactions which is electrolysis, where electrical energy is converted into chemical energy, right? So we have discussed this in the previous lecture, that spontaneous reactions are used to convert chemical energy into electrical energy, right? And the example that we have taken is, so in this video lecture we will understand in detail how a galvanic cell works and how the arrangement is done in galvanic cell to convert chemical energy of a spontaneous redox reaction into electrical energy, right? So galvanic cell where chemical energy of spontaneous redox reaction is converted into electrical energy, right? This arrangement is galvanic or voltaic cell. So the example of spontaneous reaction, right, that we will take is the reaction between zinc and copper sulfate, right? And the reaction that took place was plus copper, right? So here what actually happened is, zinc, we know that zinc is more reactive than copper, right? If you look in the activity or reactivity series that we have done in previous class 10th activity reactivity series, not in 11th, I'm sorry. So in the activity or reactivity series, the reactivity of metal decreases as we go down the series, and we know that zinc is above copper, so zinc is more reactive. If we say zinc is more reactive, that means it can easily get oxidized, it can easily lose its outermost electron and will form zinc ions, and the electrons that are lost by zinc would be gained by copper in this chemical reaction. And this reaction is taking place spontaneously. We are not providing any kind of energy to this reaction. It's happening on its own, right? So these kind of reactions are used to make electric current. So here zinc will lose two electrons and it will form zinc ions. Similarly, the electrons that are lost, the electrons that are lost by zinc in this reaction would be taken by copper ions that are in this solution, right, to form copper metal. So this is your oxidation reaction and this is your reduction reaction, right? And reactions where these two take place together, we call them as redox reaction, right? So now, since I said that spontaneous reactions, the chemical energy of spontaneous redox reaction, this is a spontaneous reaction, we know that spontaneous reaction, the chemical energy of spontaneous redox reaction is converted into electrical energy, right? Now let's see how we can use this reaction to make electric current, right? Now in this reaction, this oxidation reaction and this reduction reaction is taking place in a single beaker, that is this electron, right, this electron got transferred directly to copper in this beaker, right? So these are known as, this kind of reaction is known as direct redox reaction. This is known as direct redox reaction, where electron is directly transferred from zinc to copper in the single beaker, right? And this solution became hot, we noticed, right? It became hot because of the energy, that is, the chemical energy got converted into heat energy, right, in this reaction. So the energy that got produced, we could not make any good use of that electricity. If we carry out the reaction in this form, that is in a single beaker, we could not make use of this reaction. Now let's see what Luigi Galvani and Alessandro Volta, they are the two scientists who performed this reaction, right, these spontaneous reactions to convert chemical energy into electrical energy. Now let's see how they carry out this reaction to make electric current. This oxidation reaction and this reduction reaction, in this reaction is being done in single beaker. So in the arrangement of galvanic cell, right, this is in honor of Luigi Galvani, right, and voltaic cell is in honor of Alessandro Volta, right, because they converted first chemical energy into electrical energy. So what they did, they carried out these two oxidation and reduction reactions into separate beakers instead of the single beaker, right, and they used this electron that got transferred from zinc to copper to produce electric current. Let's quickly see what arrangement that they did. What they did to carry out this reaction, this oxidation reaction, they took one beaker, right? This beaker has zinc sulfate solution, right? And a rod was dipped in this electrolyte. This is your zinc rod, right? So in this reaction, we will take two beakers. In one beaker we will do oxidation, in another beaker we will do reduction. So we have physically separated the oxidation and reduction part of this chemical reaction. Right? This was the chemical reaction, so we will separate the oxidation and reduction part of this chemical reaction. Now we will take another beaker. Right, this has copper sulfate solution and a copper rod is dipped in it. Right, so zinc is in this half cell of this reaction, and copper sulfate solution is in this half cell of this reaction. Right, so we are doing this reaction in two separate beakers, same reaction. So what we do is, we will connect these two rods via this copper wire and we put one galvanometer here, right? We know that galvanometer is used to detect current, and we said that we will do this reaction to make electric current. So if this galvanometer will show deflection, that means electric current is produced. So we will look at this galvanometer when we will do this reaction in the lab, right? So let's see how this reaction will go. We have zinc rod here, this oxidation reaction where zinc is losing two electrons, right? So that means zinc will lose electrons, right? So here zinc will lose two electrons, it will form zinc ions, right? So the first reaction is done in this beaker, right? Where zinc, we have zinc rod in this beaker, right? So this reaction will take place in this beaker. Zinc will lose two electrons to form zinc ions. Now, just notice one thing, that this electron will stick to rod, that is zinc rod, and this will go to solution. Right, this will go to solution like this, right, and this will stick to, these are electrons, these will stick to this rod, these are negatively charged. So these electrons will make this zinc rod negatively charged, right? So these electrons got stick to this rod and they will move through this copper wire. This is the copper wire through which these two electro rods are connected, right? This is how these electrons will move. This is the direction of electron flow, right? When these electrons will come here, if you look at the second reaction, copper sulfate, right? So we have copper ions plus sulfate ions in this beaker, sulfate ions, right? So this, where copper ions will gain electrons to form copper metal. So electrons traveling through this copper rod will enter this rod, through this rod, right? And these copper ions, right? These copper ions that will collide with this copper rod will gain electrons, right? Will gain electrons to form copper metal. We have copper ions that are moving in this solution. So when they collide with this copper rod, they will gain these electrons that are coming from zinc rod and will form copper metal. From this solution, these electrons are coming from zinc to this rod. Through this rod, it will enter this solution, right? Copper ions will gain these electrons to form copper metal, right? So since copper ions are taking electrons from this rod, right, as a result of this reduction reaction, because we know that copper has high reduction potential, that is, it can easily take electrons in preference to zinc. So copper will gain electrons, right, from this rod. So when it will gain electrons from this rod, this electron will become electron deficient. So when it will become electron deficient, it will acquire a positive charge, right? You will have positive charge on this entire rod. Now notice one thing. Now in both the reactions, okay, here reduction is taking place, this reaction, and here oxidation took place, right? The first reaction. So the two parts of this galvanic cell, these two beakers or these two parts of this galvanic cell are called half cells, right? These are half cells, and the half cell in which oxidation takes place is known as oxidation half cell, right? And this half cell where reduction reaction takes place, this is known as reduction half cell, right? Since this is in the left, this is also known as left half cell. This is in the left, so we call it as left half cell, and this is in the right, so we also call it as right half cell, right? Now just keep one thing in mind, that in any galvanic cell, the reduction part, the reduction half cell, is always in the right and oxidation is always in the left, right? So we say oxidation half cell is always in left and reduction half cell is always in right, right? So this is the basic arrangement. Now let's see one thing. I said that the zinc ions that resulted as a result of this oxidation reaction will enter into this cell. Will enter into this beaker in this solution, right? So when zinc ions will keep entering this solution, right, we will have this charge kind of thing developed. We will have lot of positive charges in this cell, right? And we know already that we have these electrons are getting stick to this rod, so we have negative charge on this rod. So negative charge is on this rod and positive charge is on solution. This positive charge resulted as a result of this oxidation reaction where zinc ions are produced, which entered into solution to make this solution electrically positive, electrically charged. Similarly, if you check the right hand half of the cell or the reduction half cell, in the reduction half cell, these copper ions from the solution are gaining electrons from this rod, right, to form copper metal, right? So copper ions are decreasing in this solution, right? We say copper ions are decreasing. Right? Here, zinc ions are increasing as a result of this oxidation reaction. And this copper ions are decreasing as a result of this reduction reaction. So slowly we know that we also have these sulfate ions, right? These are negative ions in the solution. So slowly then copper ions will become two less, but sulfate ions will remain as it is in this solution. And we know this, that sulfate ions are anions which are negatively charged. So after some time it will produce, or it will make this solution negative. This solution will become electrically charged by acquiring negative charge as a result of this reduction reaction. Right? So this half cell will become, the solution in this half cell will become negative due to reduction reaction, and this half cell will become, the solution in this half cell will become positive due to oxidation reaction. Right? So now the electrons that are getting transferred from zinc to copper, let's see what will happen to these electrons. Since the solution has become positive, and we know that there is force of attraction between electrons, or the negative charge and the positive charge. Now we have positive charge on this solution, it will not allow these electrons to move out from here due to the positive charge in this solution, right? Because we know electrons are negatively charged and these ions are positively charged. So these ions will try to attract these electrons, or they will not allow these electrons to move out. They will not allow these electrons to move out. Yeah. So, and let's see what will happen in this half cell. In this half cell, we see that a negative charge is developed in the solution, right? And electrons are entering into this half cell. Electrons are negatively charged, and this solution is negatively charged. So negative charge on electrons will repel this negative charge on solution. So negative, negative repel. So when we have negative charge developed on the solution, this negative charge will not allow electrons to enter into this half cell. Now see the situation from here. It's not allowing this electron to move out due to positive charge on the solution, and due to negative charge in the reduction half cell, this is not allowing electron to come in. So what electron will do? Electron will stop moving. So when electron will stop moving, there would be no current flowing. So current will stop flowing in this reaction, in this cell, in this galvanic cell, in some time, right? After some time. Why? Because of these electrical charges that got developed in these two half cells, right? So we say that current will stop flowing as a result of electrical charge.